It's in everything. You can search lead in children's foods, mercury in children's foods. But if there's a much lower level in a children's toy, they'll have a big recall. Everyone will gather around and get scared. And the government will have billboards up warning you. Everything's about how they care about you and they want to help you. They'll always focus on some little bitty thing that isn't really a problem, comparatively, and then ignore the giant problems. But there's lead, mercury, arsenic, it's all in there. Because do you know what they do with the distillates from oil production? All the things they can't use that are toxic waste, they mix it with fertilizer, hundreds of chemicals. And they then spray it as fertilizer onto the crops, and plants are very good. In fact, they use corn to detoxify land that's had problems. They will suck it up. And then you eat it. They will suck it up and you eat it. Now, does LeBron James and Lindsay Lohan and Mel Gibson really matter now? Does your waistline really matter? No. Fighting these people does. And the sun is going to burn into a cinder. Before we ever pass this way again.
Ever pass this way again,
and we're gonna rise,
and we're gonna rise, we're gonna rise, ride like a one-eyed jack of diamonds with the devil close behind.
We're gonna start the second hour, and I'm gonna go to Tim, TJ, Eddie, Tim, Ronnie, and others. The toll-free number to join us is 1-800-259-9231. Bob Chapman's coming up in the third hour today to talk about the economy. Coming up, also, BP says they've stopped the oil leak in the Gulf of Mexico, but we've got screenshots of their cameras down there, and it looks like there may be some hanky-panky going on, but we are looking into it right now and working on that. But if this is true, praise God, this is certainly wonderful news. We'll be talking about that and discussing it coming up after we go through a bunch of your phone calls. Also, the head of the United Arab Emirates, their ambassador, says country may back a U.S.-Israeli attack on Iran. This is very serious news out of Der Spiegel and also the Saudi Arabian newspapers and Business Insider. So we're going to be breaking that down coming up. Another economic report here from Yahoo Finance. The U.S. middle class is being wiped out. Here's the stats to prove it. And we'll also then get into Kagan. There may be a filibuster of her if Senator Jeff Sessions decides to take action. We need to put pressure on Senator Sessions, who's done some pretty good work in the past, one of the better senators up there, and say, look, you have a duty to filibuster this monster who's anti-free speech and Second Amendment and private property and anti-family. It doesn't matter if she still gets confirmed. You have a responsibility to expose her as the monster she is, so there's more pressure on her once she's a Supreme Court justice to not double back. And she did engage in perjury before another congressional hearing when she was confirmed as Solicitor General. And the first thing she did when she got in was double back on what she'd promised. So this woman is unfit to be a toilet attendant. The globalists are lining up all their ducks to launch an attack on Iran. More on that coming up. More on the economy as the middle class is being eradicated, and even mainstream news is reporting on it. We're looking into BP's claim, because they've done this many times, that they have stopped the oil leak in the Gulf. We're looking at the pressure readings and other things that are public and doing some research on that. So that's coming up later in the hour. But right now, let's go back to your phone calls. Tim in Michigan, you're on the air.
Hey, Alex. I hope you can hear me today.
Yes, I can.
Okay, good. Yeah, I was having a little trouble with a new phone yesterday. Thanks for letting me get back with you again this week. You know, I don't know how you do it, but you hit on a talking point that not a lot of times people will bring up. And what you had mentioned this morning earlier before I got through to talk to you was about how once you obtain this information and the truth, basically, how much it does change your outlook on how you value your life. And then I can honestly say it my life hasn't been the same. And sometimes I might even be asking for some advice here, buddy, but sometimes it's really hard to find some balance and to try to even maintain a reasonable amount of what my God-given right by the Constitution, my right to be happy.
Well, listen, Tim, we got out of balance. Thomas Jefferson, George Washington, Thomas Paine, Patrick Henry, they all said you must guard the jewel of liberty. You must do everything you can in its defense. It is, of the prime importance. Even if you struggle to keep freedom, you're probably going to lose it, and you will go into bondage, and the worst elements of society will take over. And so we've gotten out of balance as a society, becoming decadent, fat, and happy. So the evil crept in. Now we're going back into bondage. The blessings of liberty we're now losing. And so what did Barry Goldwater say? Extremism in defense of liberty is no vice. There is no such thing as being out of balance. We need the 100% effort in waking people up, in reaching out to people. That doesn't mean you don't spend time with your family. But when I'm spending time with my family out at the lake fishing or at a local park or on a hike and bike trail or watercoloring, sitting on the floor, I just get closer to God. I see their innocence, their beauty, their goodness, their wholesomeness. And it just, so my mind's really split while I'm thinking about them and loving them and nurturing them and loving my wife. I'm also thinking about how I've got to oppose evil and having brainstorms of different ways I can warn people. And what's interesting is 10 years ago, I've been married for almost 9, but 10 years ago, even 6-7 years ago, I would still see a beautiful woman in a grocery store and lust. I would still, I have a lot of flesh. And now almost all of that is burned away. I mean, I'm attracted to my wife, but still my drive states are fully survival, warn people, deal with this, protect my children. And anything else, Tim?
Yeah, a couple real quick things here. You were talking about, what people look at as important these days. And when I crack open my Yahoo page, which is my home page, they have this thing called Trending Now. And you'll see stuff like Lindsay Lohan, American Idol, Raw Wrestling, Dancing with the Stars. And then the sixth thing at the end of the very last article, guess what it was?
What?
The BP oil spill. That's what kind of priorities our country has these days.
That's a great point. Is what is that trend you're looking at? Google Trends or what is it?
No, it's on my Yahoo. I have a Yahoo.
I meant to write a story about that. I'm gonna talk about when we come back. Great points, Tim. God bless you. You are in balance, Tim.
Waging war on corruption.
All right, you want to go?
It's Alex Jones coming to you live from the front lines of the info war.
It is Friday, 16th day of July, 2010. Humanity is under attack by a scientific technocracy hell-bent on exterminating at least 80% of the world population. They're building the kill grid right now. All of the mass poisoning and genetic engineering has only been a test. The real war is about to begin. Prepare yourselves and get right with your creator. And that doesn't mean I'm on some high horse here. The reason I don't like to drink, and I like to drink as much as anybody, is because that's when I find myself lusting after other women. That's when I find myself not thinking about fighting the New World Order. That's when I find myself cussing and allowing corrupt thoughts into my mind and not being focused. And it's the same thing when I immerse myself in Hollywood movies and distractions that the world puts out there. None of us are perfect, but we have to realize the better traits in humanity and reach for those instead of just giving in to corruption.